Democrats picked up their first big victories in years after winning gubernatorial races in Virginia and New Jersey. Pundits viewed the contest as a referendum on President Trump and his policies. CBS's Mola Lingi reports from the White House.
Democrats picked up big wins in gubernatorial races Tuesday. In New Jersey, Phil Murphy beat Republican Kim Guadagno 56-42%. And in Virginia, Dr. Ralph Northam defeated Republican Ed Gillespie 54-45%. The newly elected governors say their wins show Americans want unity.
The politics that is tearing this country apart is not, that's not the United States of America that people love. It's certainly not the Commonwealth of Virginia.
We declare the days of division are over.
But party leaders from Washington are viewing the victories as a direct repudiation of President Trump and his policies.
People are so sick of these Twitter tirades. They want leaders they can be proud of. And that's why people like Phil Murphy and Ralph Northam were able to win, because they're sane.
President Trump took a different view on things. He tweeted, Ed Gillespie's loss was because the Virginian did not embrace him or his policies. President Trump's push to kill Obamacare was at the forefront of many voters' minds as they went to the polls. CBS News exit polling revealed health care was the number one issue for voters in Virginia.
If there's anything Democrats may take away, it's that seeing health care as the number one issue may give them some ideas on how to campaign heading into 2018.
Republicans did pick up a win in Utah, where Republican John Curtis easily won the race to replace Jason Chaffetz's congressional seat. Mola Lengi, CBS News, the White House.
And John Curtis is currently the mayor of Provo, Utah, and says he's going to focus on health care reform, tax reform, and balancing the budget when he gets to Washington.